next is our one state is going to be represented, which is very much highlighted due to its success with the treatment of the coronavirus. Just for your information, yesterday India got 16,922 new cases of the corona. And alone in Delhi, it is the 3,788. And if you compare it with the US, the data of the last 24 hours of US is 36,888. This much infection is just being carried out. But one state is here in our India, the Kerala, which has controlled it phenomenally. And the speaker is from the very good, having the legacy, where the MD is celebrating 99 year of his birthday, Dr. P.K. Varier. And you understand that I'm going to invite Mr. C. Jayadevan, who is the MD Kachikasa from the IPJTR Gujarat University Jamnagar, and having a lot of experiences, clinical experiences, and all the academic career. And basically he started one thing, that is the Kuttakal Ayurveda School of Excellence. And they are doing wonderful, amazing. And I invite Professor Jayadevan on the board to address the Kerala experiences, the dealing with the COVID-19. Professor Jayadevan, please.
Thank you, Dr. Chaudhary.
Yeah, welcome.
Respected all dignitaries, all the participants who are here in this webinar. At the outset, I should say that public health intervention is not only about finding some medicine or giving some medicine. From Ayurvedic medicine, it is also about many other components. So it is with this spirit I am participating in this, because our hospital is also a corona care center, but and we are giving preventive medicines, but not directly treating with the severe cases. But of course, we are doing a lot of things. We have some planned in a structured way. So I am going to present those activities, especially under the government of Kerala, what we are trying to do. With this introduction, let me start. Let me share the screen. Some experiences of Kerala. Of course, we are mainly concentrating on Ayurveda, not the full allopathic medicines. Also, I'm not going to cover. The first case, the index case in India, in Kerala, one student from Kerala, from Wuhan, reported positive. And that was announced by government of India itself. And from that day onwards, the first day, when the first case was diagnosed, from that day onwards, we started our planning, and the whole government machinery started working. So on February 4th itself, government of Kerala declared coronavirus as a state calamity. And on March 15th, we started our campaign as a break the chain campaign. It is very popular campaign in Kerala. Maybe due to the high literacy rate, people started following those instructions from the government. On March 23rd, after 30 new cases were reported, Kerala announces lockdown. So, and after that, government of Kerala constituted various committees. They about some 16 or 17 committees, and they opened a war room. The government secretariat, under the guidance of ICMR experts, under the leadership of health minister, we started the whole work. And we realized that, the government realized that the best way of preventing COVID-19 infection is break chain campaign and enhancing the immunity of the individual and identifying the infection early and timely medical intervention, etc., etc. And Ayurvedic intervention started at that period itself. Not as an organized manner. There was preventive strategies as a first phase. They started on 15th itself. And we delivered medicine up to 2,17,878 patient individuals we have given the medicine. But that was not in an organized fashion. And just before the government came into picture. On March 30th, we had a video conference and all the experts assembled. And the chief minister directly chaired the session, and he insisted that our previous experience in tackling the Nipah virus and the Chinese experience, he said traditional medicine has got a role to play, and especially the Ayurveda has a role to play. So you must come in, and within some 2 days you give a proposal, detailed proposal. So within 2 days we given a proposal. So initially we thought there should be some different groups. First in quarantine and home quarantine isolation groups we should give medicines. And also with mild symptoms we should have medicines, it's separate medicines. An integrated approach in case of vulnerable groups like lactating mother, children, etc., and geriatric care. And also even after the patient is cured, in the convalescent period also we should give some Ayurvedic medicine. So this was the suggestions by the expert. That means not that just giving one medicine as a curative thing, but you should classify in different stages, only then our approach will be scientific. This was our impression. All the experts suggested this. Then we submitted, within 2 days, we submitted a strategies for the implementation of Ayurveda in the prevention, mitigation and rehabilitation. Prevention, mitigation and rehabilitation. Of course, I should say that in case of mitigation, we have not done so many things. But of course, there are some observations in the case of mitigation also when Ayurveda medicine was given. So this was the report given, and these are the contents of the whole project, including the, we have informed the government regarding the facilities and what we have and the medical system, what is available in Kerala and from the Ayurvedic point, and Ayurvedic strategies for mitigation, data analysis, everything. It was a very exclusive thing. And the state government declared a state Ayurveda COVID-19 response cell, which is called a SCRC, in the government secretary under the AYUSH ministry, AYUSH department. We started a systematic work, an administrative setup. From the Trivandrum, from the central administration, there is some response cell under which there are regional centers, the Ayurveda colleges, government colleges are working as regional centers. And of course, we have district level director, DMO and medical officers are involved. And in the ground level, government Ayurveda hospitals, government Ayurveda dispensaries, national admission projects, medical colleges are working as the ground level units. This is our framework, which is called as, the whole projects are implemented as Ayurveda clinics. It is called as Ayurveda clinics. This started spreading message of Ayurveda and importance in good health. And all the government institutions, we have Ayurveda clinics now, and it provides medicines, preventive medicines to improve the people's immunity and health support to all the people. And Chief Minister himself declared, inaugurated the whole project. And now we have so many Ayurveda clinics in the state, and there is a task force. We formed a different task force at the ground level, and each LSGD local self government heads were involved, and health standing committee chairperson, medical officer, ward member, HMC member, ASHA workers, private practitioner, and most importantly, Ayurveda medical students were also involved. So this is a team. It's a public-private model. It's a task force we formed, and this task force is now controlling the whole distribution of medicine and Ayurvedic strategy, etc. These are the number of clinics district-wise, and we have 1,206 Ayurveda clinics right now working very effectively in all the districts in Kerala now. Ayurvedic preventive strategy. Out of this, we have distributed medicine for 1,69,930 recipients all over the state through these centers. Already we have distributed, and our the whole Ayurvedic intervention is through four distinct programs. The first program is Swasthyam, which is intended for less than 60-year-old youngsters and all those people who are in quarantine, and even the family members, etc. And the Sugayasham project addressed the people above 60 years, and also the Amrutam project, which is actually the most effective public intervention project that we have done. And also we have Punarjani, the interventions in the convalescent period. So these are the four major interventions, major projects that we are implementing in the ground level through Ayurveda clinics. The Swastham is about mainly we have so many patients in quarantine in Kerala, because people come from outside India, they already returned. And also we have about our experience when working in Swastham, we found that quarantine means it is not only keeping away from yourself from the society, but you call it house quarantine, even the room quarantine also. We find that in the family members are not disciplined. They are not keeping the social distancing, etc. Maybe mainly because of the facilities in the home. Maybe there is no separate room to provide for a corona patient or a chance for those who are there is chance of infection because they come from outside. So we have a lot of experience in this project. We mainly focused on healthy food, yoga, exercise also. And in the other project was Sugayusham in geriatric care. And we had a very thorough documentation and follow-ups, evaluations, and medicines that we distributed to all the patients. And I should say that this was the first proposal model of reverse quarantine in the state. We talk about reverse quarantine now, but Ayurvedic fraternity start the reverse quarantine. That is our experience. We said that in the initial itself, the initial thought was that we should have a separate strategy for people with 60 years above. So that was a strategy. Later on, the old model was copied everywhere. So the reverse quarantine was a good experience as far as the Sugayusham project was concerned. And district-wise number of this project was beneficiaries were 1,29,833 patients. But individuals got benefit of this, and none of them has reportedly tested positive COVID-19. That is what is a very encouraging finding that we got. And another project was Amrutam. It's for giving medicines or preventive medicines to those in quarantine. And it was commenced on 17th May. And a nearly total of 50,000 individuals already we have addressed. 50,000, you can imagine. All the medical officers, every day, they are sitting at home. They are calling them. They are getting the list from the district administration and asking from where you have come. Is there any problem? Any other problem you have other than anything we want to do? Then if you are willing, if you are concerned, we are ready to give medicines. And all the medical officers take the medicines and to home, and they distribute and get the consent form signed and get the data, and we fill the form and we systematically collect the data. Rigorous follow-up regimen has been associated to the program. Even after the 14 days, we give medicines, and we have thorough contacts with those people, and even we have WhatsApp group also with them, and they ask the medical officer what to do, Ayurvedic medical officer what to do after 14 days. This is our experience. So this was very effective and very encouraging program, and immense people's demand. Now earlier we were asking whether you want, you give the consent, but now the people started asking us, even the Asha workers and the health missionary and the Panchayat, they asked, contact Ayurvedic doctors and ask them, can you give the medicines for quarantine people, or please give some medicine. So there is a lot of demand from the society. The initial stage, we were asking the quarantine persons whether you need Ayurvedic medicine, but now the things are reversed. So this was very encouraging, and the initial observation is that less incidence of positive cases in such groups, and also total cure in individuals with mild symptoms, and also we find that if at all they are affected, it's a speedy recovery. We have very less number of cases tested positive. But if tested, we notice that there is a speedy recovery. This is the initial observation. Of course, we will be publishing our data, because there is systematic, every day the medical officer is supposed to upload the data. So we are systematically collecting, research oriented. We will come up with the data in the later phase. In Punarjani is another scheme. We are giving medicines for the patients, for the individuals in care. And only we have recently started. This is the initial data in all over the state. We only have 111 cases, but now it has come to 250 today. So this is another scheme, Ayurvedic medicine in a convalescent phase. This was the fourth scheme. And we also addressed the other high-risk group population, like policemen, health workers, and destitute people, and beneficiaries were 32,274 people. Benefited out of it, and it was through government missionary we have done. The whole state government supported, and the Ayush department initiated the whole project, and we could address this much of people. And commonly used medicines are Indugandham, Sudarshana tablets, Vilwadi tablet, and drinking water, boil water with the Shadanga Kashaya Churna, We asked all the people to take only Sharanga boiled water. This was the routine practice for 21 days at least. And Agastya Rasayana, Chyavanaprasha, and Shimulagadatra, and many other medicines for in according to the tailor-made prescriptions based on the symptoms. And there are many other instructions given. Time is, it's already 40 minutes, so I'll try to conclude. We have other few projects like Kude Ashram. Kude is a project on mental health, and we started some counseling also, giving some mental health support along with the Indian System of Medicine, the whole department, and different organizations. We started some telecounseling projects also. It was very encouraging. We utilized the service of 260 Ayurvedic doctors, postgraduate students of our institution, our alumni, and we started this project, and later on it was converted in as a state level project. We started screening, we called the patients, then quarantine counseling. We had a lot of other issues also, because especially in the Gulf countries, in a room there will be some 15 persons staying, and one person is infected and others know that he is infected, but there is no other way. They have to live with that person, infected person. So they had a lot of mental trauma. So we had to give mental health support in various ways. So we utilized the other different methods for counseling. And even the district collector also shared in the Facebook our initiatives. And there are so many other details, but the time is very short. And we have addressed all different types of different categories of people, including non-residents, Indians, and non-resident Keralites. And this Kude, the project was very popular in Kerala now. And we have through, as Chaudhuriji was telling, that we have an organization called CASE, Kottakkal Ayurveda School of Excellence. So we have done some capacity building exercise, and we have given some certificate course for preparedness in public health emergencies, and also certificate program in mental health support, and a total beneficiaries of 272 patients, 272 Ayurvedic doctors. And Harsham was another interesting project for mental health support, and this was the, and I'll conclude with saying one more last project. That was Ayur Shield clinics, which are now getting momentum in Kerala. We have nearly 600 Ayurvedic clinics we have started in private sector, because we thought that we should involve the private sector also, not only the other previous projects I was discussing was through government missionary alone. Now we are involving the private people also, and we have CII and the manufacturers organization and Hospital Management Association involved, and in every hospital we have separate clinics now called Ayur Shield clinics. So this was inaugurated by the Chief Minister, and also we have interesting some observations, and we hope that in the next level this Ayur Shield clinics will be continued as a complete healthcare package for Ayurveda even after the COVID-19. This is going to be very crucial for Ayurveda in Kerala. Ayur Shield clinics are going to be very organized clinics which will be catering the needs of Ayurveda, the people of Kerala, in more organized way than before. And the Ramya is another portal the government is running. It is an online portal collecting all government Ayurveda facilities. And also we have online consultation. We have rigorous setup for our data collection and analysis. And Aparajita Dhoomam, I should say that this is the one main Dhoomam, which is very popular in Kerala now. I think it should be propagated in all over India, because this is very successfully we have practiced in the last season of Nipah virus and pandemic. So this is very popular now. These are the ingredients, and these are the some of the studies conducted regarding Avirajita Dhuma Churna. And finally, I should say that we are also supporting the modern epidemiological wing under government in the district level. Our PGs and house surgeons are, we have a satellite unit in the campus. Mainly we are doing the contact tracing, and our nearly 100 house surgeons and PGs in total, we are involved under the leadership of teachers. We are contact tracing also we are doing. So this is a summary of the activities what we are conducting in Kerala. And to conclude, I should say that why we have succeeded, especially in Ayurveda, Ayurvedic doctors also succeeded in this, mainly because we had a previous experience of Nipah outbreak in 2018, and also flood in 2000 subsequent years of 18 and 19. So we were involved in those projects, including we were doing some post-traumatic stress disorder we were addressing. So a lot of things we were able to do. So I think right now we have a space in public health than before, because the whole public health scenario was totally dominated by allopathic people. But now right now we have a space, by good space in public health. We cannot, nobody can, even the government cannot neglect the Ayurvedic doctors now in conducting all the activities of public health. I should definitely say that Ayurveda has played a role in flattening the curve in Kerala, even though it is not directly treating the COVID patient. That's what initially I said. It is not about only treating the COVID patients, but public health intervention is something different. And we have various aspects. And with these words, I conclude. I once again thank the organizers for giving this wonderful opportunity. I thank especially Dr. Chowdhury and Kishore Patwardhan and all of this. BHU, I have so many people, Dr. Shobhavat and so many other people I know. I thank the organizers for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you. I have taken some three, four minutes extra, but I'm sorry. There is almost a lot of activities done in Kerala. It is a very systematic way we are doing, and it's the government is supporting Ayurvedic fraternity also. And I think there are some models can be copied. So that's why I have taken some 3 more minutes. I'm very sorry. Thank you, Dr. Chowdhury.
And really, this is a torchbearer for every Ayurvedist from all over country, to how to serve the people.